Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm going to do a classic rock reaction, man. This is an album reaction. Album reaction featuring the music of the Moody Blues. And the album is entitled In Search of the Lost Chord. Now, what I'm going to do here, man, is I'm going to break this up into two parts, actually three parts, counting the review as part three. So part one and then part two. So first, before I pop this off, this is a recommendation being provided by Ford Prefect. And Ford has a note here. He said, for my next album, In Search of the Lost Chord, there are several album playlists on YouTube, but many had errors, songs in wrong order, etc. So this is the deluxe version. And you should only do the first 12 songs. Yes, it's more than 10 songs, but two of them are under 1 minute each. And there aren't any long songs. Okay, so yeah, let's do it that way then. So we'll do in part one, Departure, I guess, and then it ends with House of Four Doors, so that's six songs. And then part two will be the remaining six, Voices in the Sky, and then Om being the last one. So that's how we're going to do it, man. And maybe down the road, we might do a little bit more of this deluxe version, this deluxe album. All right, so starting with part one, In Search of the Lost Chord. Let's get it.
Be it sight, sound, smell, or touch, there's something inside that we need so much. The sight of a touch, or the scent of a sound, or the strength of an oak with roots deep in the ground. The wonder of flowers to be covered and then to burst up through tarmac to the sun again. Or to fly to the sun without burning a wing. To lie in a meadow and hear the grass sing. To have all these things in our memories hoard and to use them to help.
Great song. Great song.
Thank you.
This is classic rock at its best, baby. This song to me is a great representation of how I define classic rock.
Dr. Livingston, I presume, stepping out of the jungle gloom into the midday sun. What did you find there? Did you stand a while and stare? Did you meet anyone? I've seen butterflies galore, I've seen people big and small. I've still not found what I'm looking for.
We're all looking for someone. We're all looking for someone. We're all looking for someone.
Captain Scott, you were so bold, now you're looking rather cold out there in the snow. What did you find there? Did you stand a while and stare? Did you meet anyone? I've seen polar bears and seals, I've seen giant Antarctic eels. I've still not found what I'm looking for.
Great story being told there.
Mystery spread its
did a reaction with this song recently.
About a light they say that shines so clear. So raise your glass, we'll drink a toast to the little man who sells you thrills along the pier. He'll take you up, he'll bring you down, he'll plant your feet back firmly on the ground. He flies so high, he swoops so low, he knows exactly which way he's gonna go.
Thank you. racing from one side to the other, man. That is the Moody Blues, In Search of the Lost Chord. Fantastic deluxe mix of these tunes, man. Great compilation. Yeah, you know, I find that with the Moody Blues, it's a very pleasurable listen, but at the same time too, you do have to pay a little bit of attention, because you will lose the meaning quickly because they're going from one song direction into another. But speaking about song direction, let me just real quick kind of get a feel for what we're wading into here. And anyone who, excuse me, is not really familiar with the Moody Blues and how they do, this will help both of us along the way so that we don't miss anything. Now, of course, I'm going to save the body of the reading for the review, but this is kind of like an intro just to get a feel for the content of the album and the theme. Content. There we go. In Search of the Lost Chord is a concept album around a broad theme of quest and discovery, including world exploration, music and philosophy through the ages, lost love, spiritual development, knowledge in a changing world, higher consciousness, imagination, and space exploration and departure. Wow, space exploration would go on to become the theme of the group's 69 album, To Our Children's Children, Children. To Our Children's Children's Children. So that is the embodiment of the content of this great album. Yeah, man. You come home, you sit down, long-ass day, hassle-free day, or hasslesome day at work, sit down and you chill out and you listen to this. It'll just take it all away. It'll take you on a trip, man. Out of body, let me tell you. Wow. Looking forward to part two, man. This was beautiful. This was excellent. And I forgot, you know, when you hear an artist and you forget about certain things that they've done, I forgot about Ride My Seesaw, and it just came racing back to my brain. Oh, man. Yeah. One of those great examples of the classic era, the classic touch of the creativity of the Renaissance of creativity where classic rock is concerned. That is a great representation, man. You know, if anybody ever says to you, hey, man, give me an example of what you're talking about, this creativity, this creative process back in the day, give me a song, play that song, you know, among others. But that song really represents the heart of the creative element of classic rock to me. You know what I'm saying? And that's one of the songs I would play. All right. Hey, I got to bounce, man. I got to get my ass to work so fast. But I'm going to come back, try and skip out early, finish part two off. I might have to save the review for the next day. I like to attach the review to part two, but YouTube has been kicking the snot out of me lately, man. So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, or if not, then I'll just have to save it for tomorrow morning. But I definitely want to hit up side two. Hope you enjoyed this, man. You guys have yourselves a good day. Have a safe one. And I'll catch you in side two. Peace.